Hey everyone, welcome to this week's transformation reading where I've been taking a card from this deck that I'm working on with the creator, which shows us an emotion, and then we look at transforming that emotion from one of fear into one of unconditional love and joy, peace and laughter. We're almost through the first stack. We only have one card left, so this, of course, will be the one that we will go over today. And then I'm going to take a break from these transformation readings and focus on some other types of readings that will be coming out. So if you want to see the other ones that we've done of these, the link to the transformation playlist will be at the end of this video if you want to check any of those out. So the last and final one for this stack is panic. And it's like, I'm on fire, which is how we feel when that panic mode kicks in, when we're in fear and we go into fight or flight mode. This, of course, is the flight mode. We want to run. We want to hide or get away from whatever is making us feel heated, whatever is making us feel like a failure, whatever is making us fear that we might be unacceptable, that we might be unlovable, that we might be rejectable. And so, you know, that's what this panic is all about. It's what you feel, that tightness of your heart as it starts to, you know, kick in. It's almost like the prick in the heart. It kind of feels, it's what heartbreak feels like, because that's what heartbreak really is whenever anything happens in our life. In that moment that we feel our worth is challenged, that fear kicks in, and that's what that heartbreak feels like, when your heart drops into your stomach or drops all the way down to your toes, or it feels like someone, you know, stuck a sword in it, like, you know, it does in the tarot with three swords stuck in the heart. It's like, oh my gosh. So that's what that panic feeling feels like. But what I love is the creator gives us the answer on how we can reduce that panic, and it's stop, breathe, and respond instead of react. And what that does is when we realize that we have that panic rising up within us, as soon as we feel our heart to start to feel the pressure, as soon as we start to feel our breath become shallow, you know, all these things happen when we go into fight or flight mode. The adrenaline starts flushing through our bodies. You know, blood leaves our brain, our immune system shuts down, our digestive system shuts down. It sends all this energy to our muscles to either run like crazy or to fight and defend, right? And so our body actually goes into a different state where we don't respond. It goes into reaction mode. So if we don't pause and take a deep breath, a lot of deep breaths, and calm ourselves down, we'll continue to loop in the fight or flight and continue in this reaction area mode, either, you know, like I said, running away and hiding from whatever situation's going on, or battling, you know. So this, to reduce this panic feeling, the first thing is to somehow allow those feelings to be a flag that you're heading into fear, that you're heading into panic mode, right? And as soon as you do that, it's like, what, that's how panic attacks happen. Something's triggering us, and sometimes we're not even aware it's triggering us. There's something going on in our subconscious mind or something going on out there, and we just take a deep breath as soon as we recognize it coming up, and just take a deep breath in through your nose. Just hold it for a couple seconds and slow breath out, and just slow breath in through the nose and hold it, slow breath out. And it's almost like that is what, one, it floods your body with oxygen, which helps flush out all that adrenaline that's flowing, and it starts to slow our heart down. And it's the way that through breathing techniques you can actually slow your heartbeat back down, and then that's when our brain comes back into clarity. Instead of feeling foggy and in reactionary mode, we're actually thinking clearly. and we can actually make emotionally intelligent and emotionally calm choices and respond to whatever is going on instead of, you know, these fact, you know, fast, like our heartbeat is going like this. It's the reactions that we're doing, and our mouth becomes dry. You might even hear your heartbeat in your eardrums because your heart's beating so fast and so strongly, trying to push that adrenaline through to save our lives, right? But most of the stuff that causes us to go into panic these days isn't so much about running across like a cougar or a bear or a dinosaur in our path, you know, usually not something that is really life-threatening. It's more emotional monsters that we face and we fear rejection somehow. So once we take these deep breaths and we come to this calm place, we just, you know, stop reacting as soon as we can be aware of it. Take those deep breaths, several of them, and calm down. And then we can go back and look at what was causing that panic to trigger. What are those fear triggers that are going on in our lives? And in approaching them and understanding them in a peaceful, calm way, we can kind of disassemble some triggers that we've had in our lives for a very long time when we understand where they've come from. Sometimes it takes, you know, getting professional help through counselors. You know, they're amazing individuals that have so many tools that they can provide us to help us. I know counseling really helped me with a lot of my emotional triggers. And so I highly encourage that. You know, we have this, you know, taboo, oh, I don't want to go to a counselor. That means something's wrong with me. It's like, you know what? There's something wrong with every human being in our lives because we all have this conditioning and we all have these things that are causing us to trigger. And so if we all, you know, take time to search and to know those, we would have less triggering probably because, you know, if I'm triggering, something in me causes, you know, either I'm running away, making someone going, why are they running away from me? And then they trigger, or I attack and that triggers them, you know, to run away or to defend. And the more we all individually work on our own triggers, the less triggering goes on, you know, in the world anyway. So we can do our little piece because you can't solve anyone else's triggers. You can only work on your own. All right. Well, just know as you're going throughout this week that if you have any of these panic things start to rise, just try to remember, have that feeling be a flag that, oh, I'm going into panic mode or fear's rising. Let me take some deep breaths and pause and calm down and then see what's going on, right? And just know every second of every day that you are unconditionally loved by the creator of all things, which means there's not one condition that can make you lose it. And there's nothing you can do to gain any more of it because you have 100% of it right here, right now, and you deserve it. So also know that I love you dearly, and I'm sure I'll be talking to you very soon. But until then, you take care.